Good morning, dear colleagues and my dear students. We are from the last few classes, we are discussing about the topic atmosphere. So out of that, in the last classes, we discussed about structure of the atmosphere, and we discussed pressure, air pressure and pressure belts. We also discussed wind, what is meant by wind. Today we shall look into deep into the concept of winds, and particularly we shall discuss about the classification of winds into how many different types of winds into they were classified. What are the different types of winds? We are going to discuss about this particular topic today. So on the basis of speed, as we discussed that the atmosphere, the wind are not static. They change with the time, they change with the area, they change with the direction. So on the basis of speed, direction, and the features of the wind, basically the winds are classified into three types. The first one is planetary winds. The winds which blow throughout the year in a specific direction are called as planetary winds. Next one, seasonal winds. The winds, if they are restricted to a particular region, or if they were they are restricted to a specific season, the winds are called as seasonal winds. Next and third one, the local winds. The winds which has local in character, they change their direction within a day or within hours, the winds are called local winds. So we shall discuss about these particular winds one by one. The first one is planetary winds. So the planetary winds are the winds which blow continuously and regularly above the world pressure belts. As we know, the planetary winds means the winds which blow in a specific direction throughout the year regularly without any interruption. Those winds are called as planetary winds. If you observe this globe, we know the pressure belts, the area is called as a tropical belt, tropical low pressure belt. You see, in the north northern hemisphere, this area is called as a tropical area, that is area between equator and tropic of Cancer. In this particular area, the pressure moves from, the air moves from high pressure area to low pressure area. That is subtropical high pressure belt to equatorial low pressure belt. So the air moves in this direction. Why the air didn't move in a straight direction? As we know, due to the Coriolis effect, the winds will change their direction slightly. They tilt towards either left or right. So in this way, the winds near tropical areas, they are called as planetary winds, means they move in this particular direction. So next, in the temperate zone, they move from the southwest direction. Next, again in the polar region, again they blow similar to the tropical region winds. So means we can observe three types of direction. So three types of winds here, that is on the basis of pressure. So the planetary winds on the basis of pressure belts, again they are divided into three types. First one is trade winds, second one is westerlies, and the third one is polar winds. These are called as trade winds, and these are called as westerlies, means the winds which move from the west side are called as westerlies. And the polar winds, they are also called as easterlies. Polar winds and the equatorial trade winds are called as easterlies because they almost all move from the east direction. That's why they are called as easterlies. So the planetary winds, these three types of winds, they blow continuously and regularly without any interruption, without changing their direction. So they are called as planetary winds. So on the basis of their direction and in the area in which they are blowing, they are of three types. The winds which blow in the tropical area are called as trade winds. The winds which blow in the temperate zone are called as westerlies. The winds which blow near the pole region are called as polar winds. See, winds that blow in the tropics are called trade winds. The westerlies means the winds which blow in the temperate belt. They blow from the west direction, so they are called as westerlies. The winds which blow near the polar belt are called as polar winds. See, trade winds. If you observe, trade winds move from east to west. This is east direction. This is north. This is south. So, in the northern hemisphere, here, they move from northeast direction. See, this is the northeast direction. From northeast direction, these winds reach near the equator here. So in the southern hemisphere, they move from the southeast. See, this is south, this is east, this is southeast. So in this direction, the winds blow near the equator. They move towards equatorial. So basic transport, they move from southeast direction to northwest direction. So this direction of trade winds is regular and constant. Every year and in the every season, they move and or they blow in the same direction. That you should remember. Whereas westerlies, the westerlies blow from west to east, means from this is west area towards east, see this here. And southern hemisphere also west to east. That's why they are called as westerlies, we discussed. So now in the northern hemisphere, they blow from southwest direction to the in the northern hemisphere. This is southwest. Southwest direction to, they blow towards northeast direction. In the southern hemisphere, they blow from northwest direction. So this is northwest and they blow towards southeast direction. Next, above westerlies, we have polar easterlies. As like that trade winds, these polar easterlies also move from northeast direction to southwest direction, same like that of trade winds. So polar winds, they move same like trade winds. They also move from east to west. That's why trade winds and the polar winds are called as easterlies. And the westerlies are called so because they blow from west side. So these are the basic three types of trade winds, planetary winds. So what are the effects of planetary winds? As we discussed, the planetary winds will blow in a specific direction. But either pressure, as we discussed in the last class, the air always moves from high pressure area to low pressure area. Even winds also. So the pressure and wind, they are the result of the impact of lithosphere and hydrosphere on Atmosphere. As we already discussed, the lithosphere means land part, hydrosphere means water part. They have their specific characteristics. Land part, it heats up quickly and it cools down quickly. Whereas the water part, hydrosphere, it heats up slowly and it cools down slowly. So on the basis of this characteristic, the atmosphere will be influenced by these characteristics. So automatically, the pressure and wind also change as per the characteristics of water part and the land part. So we are discussing about planetary winds. Planetary winds play a key role in transporting heat and moisture across the world. As we discussed, the planetary winds won't change their direction throughout the year. So basically, these winds blow near the equatorial region. So that's why they transport heat and moisture to the different parts of the world. That is the one important thing. Next, these planetary winds are resulting in the balancing of temperature for life to survive. Because if you take polar regions, the polar regions, there the temperatures are very less. In some areas, the temperatures are minus 0 degrees. So there, the existence of life is not possible below the 0 degrees temperature. But the planetary winds, they blow from the equatorial region to other regions. They transport the heat and moisture. So they neutralize the cool temperatures near the polar regions. So where they get moderate temperatures, that leads to the existence of life, survival of life in specific areas. Next, these winds do not distribute heat or moisture uniformly, but they distribute heat and moisture or water vapor, but the distribution will not be uniform. A distribution will be uneven in different areas. So that is the main reason we can observe a difference in temperatures and difference in rainfall throughout the world. That is due to the difference distribution of heat and moisture by the planetary winds. So we can say that the planetary winds are useful for the reducing or increasing the temperatures in specific areas, and they are transporting moisture after that leads to the rainfall, as we know. So these are the important effects of the planetary winds. Next, basic winds, the second basic wind type is seasonal winds. First one is planetary winds, and the second one is seasonal winds. They blow in some seasons and some regions. Means that is the basic difference between planetary winds and the seasonal winds. Generally, the planetary winds blow in all seasons, in all regions, throughout the world. But seasonal winds will confine to specific seasons and specific regions. So that's why they are called as seasonal winds. Generally, they will change their direction. They won't blow in a specific direction throughout the year. They generally change their direction once or twice in a year, span of 1 year. For example, if you take India, India is getting rainfall due to these seasonal winds. So the rainfall in India, major portion of rainfall we are getting through the monsoon winds. So monsoon winds are the seasonal winds. So monsoon means it is a Arabic word, monsoon. It is derived from a Arabic word called as mausam. Mausam means in English it is season. So seasonal winds are in India called as monsoon winds. So we are getting rainfall through the seasonal winds or monsoon winds. So how these monsoons will be formed? Generally, monsoons are formed due to the difference in cooling of land and sea. As we discussed, the nature of characteristic of land and sea parts. the land will heats up quickly and cools down quickly. A sea part or water part, it heats up slowly and cools down slowly. So due to these difference between land area and sea area, particularly in the summer times, low pressure develop in the northwestern part of India. Northwestern part of India is consist of continental part. It was far away from the water part. So due to the summer temperatures, due to the increase in temperatures, that leads to the low pressure, formation of low pressure. So the northwestern India will be covered by low pressure belt during summer seasons. So at the same time, the southeast trade winds in Indian Ocean, they reach the equator. After reaching equator, they change their direction due to the Coriolis effect, and they turn, they take the turn towards the southwest. So they give, after they try to reach the peninsular India because it consists of low pressure belt. But the sea part, it heats up slowly. So naturally, in the areas of Indian Ocean and Arabian Ocean, that led to the formation of high pressure belt. So the winds blow from the high pressure area to low pressure area. So the winds in Indian Ocean and Arabian Sea, they move towards the continental part of the northern India. If you observe, see, these are the trade winds which blow in the equatorial region. They move towards actually southwest, northeast, northwest direction. These trade winds, they reach to equator. After reaching equator, they move towards, they have to go straightly in this direction. But after crossing equator, as we know, due to the Coriolis effect, the winds will tilt towards the right side. So in that way, they reach the high pressure winds, they move towards the low pressure area. If you observe, see, the winds are reaching towards the continental part of the India. Because the winds which blow from the Indian Ocean and the Arabian Ocean consist of moisture in the summer times, consist of water vapor. So the winds after reaching the India, they will give rain in the continental part of peninsular part of India. So these are called as monsoon rains. As we know, monsoon winds change their direction generally. But in this way, the winds blow for generally 5 to 6 months of time. Afterwards, they will get reverse. So with this effects of monsoon winds, it will give rains in the surrounding India and in the surrounding countries like Pakistan, Nepal, Bangladesh, Burma, in these areas. So after 6 months, they will get return. By the winter season, the pressure belts became reverse. The northeast trade winds cross the equator. So they reach the equator. Due to Coriolis effect, they turn as northwest monsoons. As we know, in the southern hemisphere, the winds tilt somewhat left side. So they give rain to the north and northeastern parts of Australia, if you observe. See, in this way, actually, they, after they reaching equator, they have to move in this way, but they are changing the direction. Because due to Coriolis effect, the winds tilt towards left side in the southern hemisphere. So these winds will reach this northern part of Australia or northeastern part of Australia, and they transport moisture from the Indian Ocean or Bay of Bengal, and they will give rains to the northern part of Australia. So in this way, monsoon winds will change their direction twice. During summers and in the rainy season, they will give rain in India and the south eastern parts of the continent, the Pakistan, Bangladesh. After 6 months, the monsoon winds will get reverse due to Coriolis effect. They will change their direction and they blow towards Australia and they will give rain. Why they move towards here means by winter season, high pressure belt forms in India and the low pressure belt will form in the Indian Ocean. As water part got heat slowly, low pressure belt form in the Indian Ocean, surrounding areas of the equator, near the equator, and high pressure belt forms in the continental part of India. So the wind blows always from high pressure area to low pressure area. So they try to blow towards equator, but after reaching equator, they tilt towards the left side and they reach Australia and they give rain there. So the third basic winds are local winds. Basically, these local winds influence very small area and they change their direction even daily or twice in daily. They form due to the local variation in the temperature and pressure. So as we know, the local variations are causing for the local winds. For example, if you take Visakhapatnam, which is in Andhra Pradesh, Visakhapatnam is adjacent of Bay of Bengal, sea part. As we know, the nature of land part and sea part. Land part heats up quickly, cools up quickly. Water part or Bay of Bengal, which is adjacent to the Visakhapatnam, it heats up slowly and cools down slowly. So the characteristic of land part and water part that leads to the formation of high pressure and low pressure. So the winds from ocean part, they blow towards Visakhapatnam and they reduce the temperatures of Visakhapatnam. In the nights, the winds from Visakhapatnam, they blow towards the water part. So in that way, they change the temperatures. So due to the local variations and the continental area or the distance from the sea or altitudes, these will influence the local variations on temperatures and pressure. So that leads to the blowing of local winds. Local winds are of two types. One is hot local winds and second one is cool local winds. These hot local winds rise the temperatures of that area through which they are blowing. Generally, hot local winds, they blow from the hot areas to cool areas. There, they mix up with the cool areas and raise the temperatures. The cool local winds reduce the temperatures. The cool local winds consist of cool air. They mix up with the hot air and they reduce the temperatures. So they influence the temperatures also. So the local winds blow in the lower layer of the troposphere. That is the basic one. The sea and the land breezes are one class of winds. See, the winds which blow from the sea are called as sea winds. And the winds which blow from the land are called as land winds. Actually, they are not called as winds because the characteristic, they blow for a small area. So they are called as breezes. So sea breeze and land breeze, one sort of local winds. We shall look into some examples. Example for hot local winds, Chinook. Actually, Chinook is a best example for hot local winds. The local winds blow near the Rocky Mountains, one side of Rocky Mountains in America and Canada. Actually, Chinook means snow eater. It try to reduce the snow in US and Canada and near the Rocky Mountains. Actually, Chinook is the name of American native tribes. So they settled near the Rocky Mountains. So on the name of the native tribe, it was named as a Chinook winds. It is a hot local winds. Actually, See, other side of Rocky Mountains, the wind, which consists of moisture, it try to cross the Rocky Mountains. By reaching higher spots, it cools down, and the in the form of precipitation, it gives rain. But by reaching the edges of Rocky Mountains, it almost all lose its humidity or water vapor. So the dry air cross the Rocky Mountains, and it cross and move towards other part of the Rocky Mountains. So the warm and dry air, when it reaches the other part, it leads to the increasing in temperatures. That temperatures, on that temperatures, that leads to the melting of ice in the grasslands in USA and Canada. It clear the snow during the winter times. So this is the advantage of hot local wind Chinook that blow in some parts of USA and Canada. Next, Fohen is one of the other important local wind, hot local wind near the Alps mountains in Europe. They melt snow and makes the weather pleasant, particularly during the winters. They helps in early ripening of the grapes, as the atmosphere is not, weather condition is not suitable. But with the effect of Fohen, they will get moderate temperatures, so that weather will be suitable for the ripening of grapes. Next, in India, one of the best example for hot local winds in India is Lu. Means here we have Thar desert in between Pakistan and India. Particularly during the summer seasons, the winds on the hot deserts will from west side blow towards the east in the May and June. So due to these hot winds, the temperatures will be increased, and that leads to the sunstroke to the people. So another local wind is mango shower. Here in Tamil Nadu and in Kerala, we can observe another hot local winds. Some other important local hot local winds are Simman. They belong to Arabian desert. They blow from the deserts. Yoma, another hot local wind, which blow in Japan. Norwester hot local wind that blow in New Zealand. Next, mango showers, that is also another just we discussed, that blow in India in Tamil Nadu region. Next one is cool local winds. They reduce the temperatures, cool local winds. Some of the examples are Mistral. See here, Mistral local winds near France, they influence the temperature near the Alps mountains here in France. Next, Pune in the Andes mountains region, South America. Next, Pampero cool local wind, Pampas region in South America. See, this is Pampero cool local wind, which blow towards the South American part. Bora, one of the cool local winds which blow in Europe. Parga, another important cold local winds which blow in Russia. So local winds are of two types, hot local winds and cold local winds, and they blow on the base of the characteristics of land part and the water part. So up to now we discussed about the planetary winds. So in that planetary winds, again there are three types: trade winds, westerlies, and easterlies or polar winds. Next, apart from planetary winds, we have seasonal winds and local winds. We discussed about these winds, nature of winds. Next, generally we know the concepts of weather and climate, but most of us have no idea about the difference between weather and climate. We generally use the term either weather or climate. So what is the difference between weather and climate? So as we know, atmosphere is not static. It is not stable. It is very dynamic. Means it changes time to time. It moves in all directions. It has no specific direction. The atmosphere, the air in atmosphere moves in all directions. And the atmosphere changes time to time. For example, if the temperatures are more in a specific region, but by the night, for example, if you take a desert region, in desert region, the temperatures will be very high during daytime, but very low during nighttime. So we can observe the great variation within the one day time. So they may be warm or they may turn into cool. The temperatures or the weather may be wet sometimes or may be dry sometimes. Means it changes time to time. So what is meant by weather? The condition of the atmosphere for a small period of time is called as weather. For a day, for hour, or some 1 week or few days. The condition atmospheric changes is called as weather. For example, we all see the live cricket matches. There they will give weather report. They won't give the climate report. Weather report means how was the condition of atmosphere on that particular day. On the day when the match was going on, they give the weather report. How was the precipitation? So how was the temperatures? How was the wind direction? They will specify the conditions of weather on that day. Means we can say that weather describes the atmospheric condition of a small period of time. Maximum, it describes about 10 days at most. So that is called as weather. As we know, weather can change daily, two times or three times within a day, or regularly every day. So that is the weather. Means we can say that weather will describe the atmospheric condition of limited time, small period of time. Whereas climate is nothing but the average weather condition of specific area for a long period of time is called as climate. Average atmospheric condition for specific areas. For example, if you take India, how is the weather in India today? So today is somewhat sunny, average temperatures. So that is the weather condition of India. But overall, from the last 100 years, how is the weather condition in India? No, we cannot call it as a weather condition. We can call it as how is the climate in India. Means it we are asking about the average atmospheric condition of last 100 years. So that is called as climate. Means average atmospheric condition of a specific area over a long period of time, maybe decades or maybe some years. That shows the characteristic, atmospheric characteristics of specific area. So climate descriptions are based on the average data of last month, last year, before last year. The average data, it represents the climates for decades. It won't describe the atmospheric condition of specific days. Means specific day, last month, first Friday. We mention it as the weather condition of last month, first Friday. But we won't describe it as the climatic condition. The climatic condition has a broad aspect. It describes about the atmospheric condition over a long period of time, particularly more than decades, 10 years, 20 years, 3 years or 4 years like that. So on what basis we will measure the weather condition or climatic conditions? So basically, we will measure to assume the weather condition or climate condition. We will measure temperature. How is the temperature? ప్రెషర్, విండ్, హ్యూమిడిటీ. హ్యూమిడిటీ మీన్స్ పర్సంటేజ్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ వేపర్ ఇన్ ది ఎయిర్. నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ ప్రెసిపిటేషన్. ప్రెసిపిటేషన్ మీన్స్ రెయిన్ ఫాల్, స్నో, హెయిల్ స్టోన్స్, దీస్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ప్రెసిపిటేషన్. సో దీస్ కంపోజ్డ్, దీస్ కంబైన్లీ డిస్క్రైబ్స్ ది వెదర్ కండిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఏ పర్టిక్యులర్ రీజియన్ ఫర్ లెస్ టైమ్, ఆర్ దే విల్ స్పెసిఫై ది క్లైమాటిక్ కండిషన్ ఆఫ్ ది స్పెసిఫిక్ రీజియన్ ఓవర్ ఏ లాంగ్ ఓవర్ ఏ పీరియడ్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్. So we already discussed temperature in the 8th class. We took the example Delhi and Shimla. How is the temperature in Delhi and how is the temperature in Shimla? We discussed it in 8th class. And in the previous class, last class, we discussed about pressure. And today we discussed about winds. So in the future classes, we also discuss about humidity and precipitation. So these are the elements of weather or climate. So with this, we will try to stop the lesson. Before that, try to recapitulate the important concepts that we discussed today. What are the different types of winds? Planetary winds. Next, seasonal winds, local winds. How many types of planetary winds are there? Again, there are three types. Easterlies are trade winds, westerlies, next polar winds. Describe in which pressure belts are the trade winds, westerlies and polar winds are blowing. Trade winds are blowing in tropical region, westerlies are blowing in temperate region, polar winds are blowing in polar regions. What is the effect of seasonal winds in India? They are giving rainfall. We are getting maximum rainfall through the seasonal winds or monsoon winds. Write the names of some hot winds and cold local winds. We mentioned in the lesson. So differentiate between the weather and climate. Weather confined to describe about the atmospheric condition of less time. Climate describes the atmospheric condition of a long period. What are the elements of climate? Just now we discussed the temperature, pressure, wind, humidity and precipitation. So try to get answers for these questions and write down in your notebooks. So with this, I will conclude today's lesson. I hope you all understand this particular topic. So thank you, one and all.